Let's see. Let's do some zero.
You will never win.
I gotta shave.
Round one. Fight.
Oh yeah, Sub-Zero can do the punches to them too. Sub-Zero's a little tougher.
Round three, fight!
Do you freeze twice in a combo? You can.
Sure.
You can technically, sometimes you can do three. Yeah, jab freeze, and then jab freeze is available when you're on a disadvantage. So like when the frame is disadvantage, I should say. I'll see if I can get one. Sometimes you can tell when you have it. Like if you do like a double sweep, you'll notice like who has the advantage, and you know if you have glitch canceling or not. Call it glitch canceling, but it's just like the frame is like updated after. So let's see. So I don't think I have it. Let's try on her. Double check. Yeah. So, like, instead of getting that double punch, you would get the freeze. Yeah, I'm gonna mix it up. Sub-Zero and...
Fight.
There you go. That's, see, that was a real 50% right there. That's nice. Totally unblockable. And you got like one frame to get that freeze like that. That was blockable there, but still at the same 50% combo. Sub-Zero is like one of my favorite characters. He's like one of the more like cerebral characters. I want to try him in MK1 with the Ice Clone. See how that works. Sub-Zero, we Headlocked Gaming, what is up? How are you, sir? I know I'm getting you on here late. Fight. But just messing around with the UMK3 Plus arcade board that I have. That's another thing, is this is a real arcade board. It's not emulated. Sweep.
Well done. Superb.
Let's see. Off a jump. What? Getting the freeze. What are you referring to? Yeah, and really for me, it's the like the reaction time. Like, I was doing reptile juggles before, and it was just, like, amazing, like, reliable, you know, just how it should be.
Sub-Zero wins.
You had time to freeze. You did. Fight. Jumping forward. You had time to freeze after you did a jumping forward. I don't know what you mean by that. Oh yeah, jump kick into freeze, yeah, you can do it. Timing's just a little tricky, but yeah, you can do it. Oh, fuck that up. So basically, when at the start of every match, or at some point, like right before the match, the computer chooses which character has frame advantage. So that means, like, if you do two attacks at the same time, say we both did that, whoever has frame advantage will win, even if they look like they connect at the same frame. It's just that the disadvantaged character's frame updates just a hair late, like one frame rate, one tick late, which, since that doesn't update normally, it allows you to cancel. So it still looks at the inputs like it's a normal timing, and it allows you to cancel with one extra frame. So that's why you can get like five hits before a spear with Scorpion, or, you know, two hits before a freeze or teleport uppercut. I try to make it look as fun as possible playing against the CPU, but it is arduous. pile of bodies stacked up perfectly there.
Superb.
I like doing that. Don't know why. Yeah, you can do it against a player. It's the same thing. The player advantage and disadvantage is just something that's a universal mechanic in the game. But you have to be able to either identify that you're at disadvantage by some like specific thing that happens in the game. Oh my god. Or you just guess.
Fight.
See the MK Secret Labs chair is available again. They raised the price well over $200. MK Secret Labs chair? No, I didn't even know that was a thing.
Well done.
Oh boy. Cheese them out. Oh my god. Nice Mortal Kombat gaming chair. Oh my god, $700. I don't know. There you go. 50%. Not easy to do with Sub-Zero. Two in a row, look at that.
Well done. Superb.
You can hit them as a counter on that, or punish, I should say, but I'm just not doing it fast enough. All right, so let's see if I have it this round. Yeah, I don't think I have it. I'm pretty good at the timing on it. Yeah, usually if that happens. Alright. I'm not gonna fuck around now. Shit.
Yeah.
Alright, let's give it another go.
Sub-Zero. Round one. Fight!
See, you can see why Jade is annoying. Oh my god. Yeah, this is on the OSSC, and I'm not really using any, I'm not using any blitters or anything like that. It's just straight, like, raw video. I could make it look nicer, but. Mariano, what is up? Yeah, this is ultimate difficulty level and the Master 2 on endurance mode. So, going all out, you know? Yeah, it's just much more fun.
Fight.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just, it's like a stress reliever. Laying in those 50% combos with Sub-Zero, you don't see that. A hair too fast on that. Oh my god, I didn't jump. Oh, I see why. The stick was like tilted. What the hell is this? Is that back down backpack or back down or backpack down back? Yeah, Motaro Shao Endurance I have not come across actually tonight. I'm trying to sneak that slide in there. Oh, of course.
Ha 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 ha!
Look at that. Yeah, I just know the patterns. Fatality, yes. It was like the second fatality I think I did back in 95. Sorry if it's the same combo over and over again, but when they present that opportunity, I always gotta take it with him. Whoops. What the hell is that fatality?
Round one.
The ice fight. Breath. Back down, back run. Yeah, that's what I was doing. Maybe I was too far. Is his animality forward, up, up, or something like that? Play Sub-Zero and MK3 as well.
Sub-Zero wins.
Most of the MK3 characters I played, I remember their fatalities.
Round one. Fight.
I said before, because we were still doing them back then.
Sub-Zero wins.
actually, the whiff off of the knee lift if he doesn't block. Let's just see what happens. I tried. Here we go. Oh my God. Making videos for tomorrow while I watch, taking notes too. Nice. What are you doing tomorrow? At the very least, he knows about it. We know that he shared a picture of
Fatality.
One of the MK2 hacks once. I think somebody sent it to him, and I think he shared it or something. So he's definitely aware of them. When I met him, we hadn't started working on him, so I didn't mention anything. but I don't know how he would have taken it back then. But, I don't know. I'd have to ask Drew if he's heard anything. But I doubt there would ever be any kind of feedback or anything, even if he liked it. Something I never messed around with was the 2-on-2 with tags. I know a lot of people like it, but I don't know. I would definitely limit the tagging, and it'd still be fun, but there's just like too many like get out of jail free. I'm like, I'm sure it gets you in trouble using the tags too much, but. Oh my god, do we got another run in here?